Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, good morning all. Yet again, our dear country is passing through a difficult moment. How we react to this challenge in the following days will determine the fate of our democracy, which has been brought to a great peril by this needless crisis engineered by a government that is unwilling to subject its conduct to the requirements of our Constitution. Meanwhile, I commend all Nigerians and friends of Nigeria who have expressed outrage over the unlawful removal of the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Walter Onoghen, an action which constitutes a flagrant breach of our Constitution and a frontal assault on our democracy. I want to note the universal condemnation of this unlawful act by all Nigerians, as well as the international community. I need to state that this latest action by General Muhammadu Buhari falls squarely within the pattern of executive lawlessness that has now been firmly turned into statecraft by the APC government. The serial disregard of court orders and consequent violation of constitutionally guaranteed human rights of our citizens confirms beyond all doubt that General Buhari and his government would rather obey their own whims and operate by separate rules outside the well-established constitutional order and the rule of law. It scarcely requires emphasis that this behavior is alien to democratic rule and more in line with that of a military dictator. Without doubt, the fight against corruption is crucial to good governance and the progress of our country and its development. In this context, the issue of corruption, as it relates to the institution of the judiciary, is even more crucial. As the last refuge of the common man, our judiciary must not only be above suspicion, but must also be seen to be manifestly above board. The issue at stake is not whether the Chief Justice is guilty or not, but whether his removal from office has been done in accordance with the process specified in our Constitution. As a Democrat, I must say, without evocation, that no mission or goal, no matter how noble or well-intended, should be used as a pretext for the subversion of our democracy and our democratic institutions. To create a condition that allows the Constitution and the rule of law to become secondary to any other agenda is to pave the way for tyranny. History is replete with odious dictators whose path to dictatorship started with statements of good intentions. We must therefore remain vigilant in defense of our democracy. We are all witnesses to how this government has serially assaulted the National Assembly, a separate arm of government that represents the bastion of our democracy. However, with this attack on the judiciary, General Muhammadu Buhari has set a new precedent in our democracy that has no equivalence in our history, not even in the darkest days of military dictatorship. This cannot be allowed to stand. At this juncture, I must warn the APC government to desist forthwith from taking actions that may push us further down the slippery slope towards a major constitutional crisis that could derail the electoral process. General Muhammadu Buhari must remember that he is a beneficiary of a free and fair election. It is therefore a matter of honor for him to allow a political environment and process that gives confidence to everyone. All my life, I have been a Democrat and a defender of democracy. Like all men of good conscience and patriots, I believe this present challenge has imposed on us yet again the duty to rise in peaceful defense of democracy, for which so many have laid down their lives. I also know that the surest weapon against tyranny is the democratic will of the people. Nigerians have consistently demonstrated their preference for democracy, and I am and will always remain on the side of the people of Nigeria. I conclude by expressing once again my gratitude to the international community for standing by our nation in this challenging time. However, the primary responsibility to resist tyranny and protect democracy in Nigeria ultimately lies with Nigerians. It is on this note that I call on all Nigerians to seize the opportunity of the coming general elections to vote in defense of democracy and the rule of law. We must vote out this anti-democratic government and restore our country to the path of true democracy, which is the surest way to ensure progress and prosperity for our people. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and God bless you all. Thank you very much.